Hello everyone and welcome back to another part of What's Played and Super Mario Bros. On the Nintendo Wii. This is the second castle of the game. Hooray! Okay, basically this castle can be a bit of a pain in the ass when it comes to star coins. This is a maze, similar to that of the original Super Mario Bros. Maze and of Castle 8 on the Nintendo DS version of the new Super Mario Bros. Or new Super Mario Bros. 1. Basically, this is new Super Mario Bros. 2, whatever. You can kill the fireballs in this game by popping out of lava with your ice blower, believe it or not. Watch. If I will ever do it. I guess I won't here, but you'll see me doing this video. I remember killing them. You go through the middle first, basically. Get it wrong, just for the sake of it, and come up and grab the star coin itself. And then go back around again, because you can't get a star coin right away. You have to grab it like that. So you have to go through this part twice. Got close to killing it. See? Killed it. Got 200 points for it. Bum, 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 bum. Bum, bum. Go up the top now. The top is the correct way to go. Correct. You'll hear that noise when it's correct. Now, basically, you grab that star coin by breaking our spots like it did. Sorry, I'm a bit distracted, to be honest. And then, basically, head down the bottom and come along here. The bottom is the correct way to go, for let's say, but you need to fire a fire team to be able to get rid of the piranha plants unless you basically want to time it out to get past them. But that's really pointless. Just kill them. There's no point in not killing them. Okay, hit a P-switch, grab a fur coin. And then, before the P-switch runs out, basically run up here and grab all these coins and then get past and in the middle part, or you're gonna have to go back around again and do that again. Without, you know, the fur coin being there again, obviously. Then go through the middle and wait for the noise to happen. Just keep running back and forth until the noise happens. There we go. Then when you're in here, there's another power-up right before you go and fight Roy. Trust me, I would have needed this if I didn't have a Fire Flower suit on right away. So then you just kind of run along here, ready to fight Roy. Kamek's here. Kamek's always causing trouble for Mario. Alright, he's gonna come out of the pipes with that and he's gonna, you know, hit the ground and freeze you. Basically, what you wanna do is just, kinda dodge him when he comes out of the pipes. Like, you know, be in the air when he comes out of the pipes and hits the ground, or you shrink. However, I got shrunk twice and then I figured out what I needed to do. It was basically the same as the original fight, but I just needed to basically avoid him when he was actually coming down rather than about a jump type of thing. Jump back into the pipe and then basically you do the same procedure over again. Just wait until he jumps down. Jump up here. Hit him and then do the same procedure over again with dodging all this crap. He'll jump back up there. Then he'll jump down. Eventually, there we go. And then when he fires off that again, you can basically just do that. Grab a key. Apparently Mario is number one. That's pretty much this entire level over with. The same procedure will happen with what happened in the last cutscene. Mario will run outside, Peach and Junior will be on the boat, and then you'll run off. That's pretty much what happens. Shut up. Goodbye, Junior. Then Mario runs after them again. All star coins in World 2 collected. Hooray! This is World 3, the Ice World. Strange to see an Ice World as World 3, isn't it? Oh well. Okey-dokey then. Save. Progress saved. So, around here we have the first ghost house of the game, and obviously, Fat Koopa there. Oh well. See you all in the next part.